Hi guys, what's up and welcome back to All Rounder channel. Okay, so we are all using the WhatsApp in our daily life. Before that we were using the Messenger from the Facebook, and before that a long time ago we used the SMS. If you remember the SMS by using the SIM that we used in our phone when there were no camera in the phones. Well, I remember that. Okay, so the WhatsApp is also a part of the Facebook. The Facebook is the owner of the WhatsApp also. And also the concept of the location was also introduced by the WhatsApp. You know, in WhatsApp you can just send your location and the other person knows your location. Okay, so other than this all, there is also another thing, and that is called the WhatsApp web. Okay, so with WhatsApp web you can just so easily scan a QR code that is shown on your desktop or your PC, and then whatever that is sent to your phone, the messages and all your contacts, whatever they send you, that is also displayed on your desktop or your PC. And the benefit of this is whenever you are sitting to your desktop, whether your phone is at home or whichever place, you can just use your WhatsApp anywhere on your desktop. You just have to have a working internet connection. Okay, so how you do that is you just scan the QR code by going to the web address, that is whatsappweb.com, and in your phone you just open your WhatsApp and there is an option, you can just search for that. So then it shows you the camera and then you can just scan the QR code that is displayed on the desktop. So just when you scan that, suddenly the interface of your WhatsApp on your phone is displayed on the desktop, and then you can just connect with your contacts through your desktop. Okay, so what is the process behind this? I mean, this video is just about that. This video is all about that. What is the process behind the using the WhatsApp web? How does the WhatsApp web works? How does your system knows this WhatsApp has scanned this QR code? I mean, it even works if your phone is far away from the PC, it will still work. So this is not like a connection of Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. This is just this is a connection from the server of the WhatsApp. So there is some story behind this. It's not just like Bluetooth connection which we use by connecting our headphones to our phone, and what sends to phone we hear on the headphone. So it's not like that. Okay, so here is how it works. Okay, so there are three things in this. One, WhatsApp is installed in your phone and you have registered your ID with your phone number. And then there is desktop in which there is the QR code shown. The third thing is the WhatsApp itself, the WhatsApp servers. So where does it start? It starts from the desktop. When you open your desktop and you open whatsappweb.com, so there a QR code is shown just like this. So this QR code is actually a code, it contains numbers. So now what you do, you open your WhatsApp on your phone and then you scan this QR code. So what happens is that the WhatsApp on your phone scans this code and it sends this code to WhatsApp server. So the WhatsApp already knows your ID because your phone number is registered, and your phone just sent this code to WhatsApp by using your phone number. So what happened is that WhatsApp has just known that your phone number sent the QR code. So now it will check where on earth this code was displayed on any desktop, because that also was displayed by the WhatsApp web, by the WhatsApp server. That code was displayed on some computer which has some IP address and some MAC address, machine address, and the WhatsApp server knows that. I think all the information is with the WhatsApp, so everything is linked now. In short, the WhatsApp received the code from your phone number that was displayed on a system. So it means that whatever will be received to your phone, WhatsApp server will send it to that system on which the code was displayed, the QR code. So it means that there are now two interfaces of your WhatsApp. Both will work simultaneously. And even if you go away from your system, your desktop, you will still receive the messages on your system. So you will have to take care of that, because if you are away and you will think that you are now disconnected, but you will not be, and you will receive your private messages on your desktop. Okay guys, so that's it. Thanks for watching, and leave a like to this video and do subscribe for more upcoming content and visual effects, and see you guys in the next video.